शंकरम लोकशंकरम शंकरम शंकराचार्यम केशवम बादरायणम सूत्र भाष्य कृत वंदे भगवंतौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरौ गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्रीचिद्घन गणेशाय नमो। मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपयोः अधिष्ठानं बुद्धिबोध्यं बुद्धेर्द्रव्यत्वनिर्मलं अपारं सर्ववेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेवाहं नमत्तोऽन्यत् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः। सो इन द लास्ट पार्ट वन मोमेंट So in the last part, we are looking at the visheshanas added in the Mangalacharana Shloka. Having looked at the visheshanas, now the author is justifying or analyzing the various visheshanas which are added and why they are needed. And they are looked at in pairs. So Sukham and Nityam together, then Nityam and Swaprakasham, Swaprakasham Vyapakam and so on, they are looked at pairs. So with the earlier, the latter is justified. So with Sukham, what happens if only Sukham had said what kind of dosha would accrue? Thereby Nityam was introduced. And with Nityam, having said Nityam, what doshas accrue? Ativyapti dosha. Thereby Swaprakasha is included. And so goes on the analysis, because Tarkashastra says that in definitions, whenever you have a definition, that time you need to have it applicable only to what is being defined. If it is too wide, then the definition reaches over to something else. That is called an ativyapti dosha. For example, if you want to define cow, so the classic example is always gauhu, go shabda. So with go shabda, gauhu, you want to define the padartha gauhu, the cow. So you define it by whatever has cowness is cow. So what is cowness now? Gotvam kim? What is gotvam? So the classical example used there with describing all the three doshas. If it is overreaching, if it is too broad, wide, then it is called as ativyapti dosha. If it is too narrow and it does not cover all cows, then it would be called as avyapti dosha. And further, if it is impossible to apply to any cow, then it is called as asambhava dosha, impossibility. These are the three doshas to a lakshana. That was given in the tippani there. The tippani, the first tippani, it is a alakshya lakshanasya sattvam ativyaptihi, lakshayika desha asattvam avyaptihi, and laksha samanya Samanya asattvam asambhavaha. This is what I explained right now. So in the gotvam, gotvam kim? What is the gotva? There you say that gotvam, you define gotvam as, say, pashutvam gotvam. Pashutvam, pashu is an animal. So pashutvam is gotvam. Of course, cow is an animal, but cow is not the only animal. So it will reach to all the lakshana, covers the lakshya, which is too wide, it covers all animals. So that is ativyapti dosha. It goes to all animals. And avyapti would be if you say, say kapilattvam gotvam. So Kapilaptum is the tawny or the brownish orange, that kind of a color that you see in the cow, especially the Desi variant, the local cow, Gir cow, etc. There, but we there the it covers those kind of cows, but it does not cover other cows, other colored cows. Of course, it has the Ativyapti dosha also, but we focus only on the Avyapti. So that is the Avyapti dosha. It is too narrow. It does not cover all cows. Asambhava would be, I think Asambhava, the example given is Ekashapavatvam. So Ekashapavatvam, the hoof that the cow has, it is never one. So it is an impossibility that the Lakshana Ekashapavatvam talks about Gotvam. The right definition as per Nayayikas is Sasnadimatvam Gotvam. So Adipada can include anything else, but Sasna. Sasna is the dewlap, which is the loose skin which is there at the neck. So that is Gotvam. Only a cow has it. So that is a perfect definition. Now what has happened with these Visheshanas which have been given, there is Gauravam. We'll see why there is Gauravam at the end. But right now the Avyapti Doshas not being there, Ativyapti Doshas being there are being negated. With each word, a single word, there can be an Ativyapti Dosha. With the other put together, there won't be. And so many Visheshanas are given, there cannot be any Dosha. There can be Gauravam, of course, but Gauravam is not considered as a Dosha. Not so much of a Dosha. So the second pair is Nityam and Swaprakasham. Nityattva Matra Uktau Nyayamata Siddha Kala Akashadi Nitya Padartheshu Ativyaptehe Tadvaranaya Swaprakasham Iti. Akashadinam Nityatvyapi Nyayamate Tesham Jadatvena Swaprakashatva Bhavat Na Ativyapti. So Nyayika says that Akasha is Nitya. Akasha is Nitya. We say that this Apekshika Nityattvam. It is not really Nitya. It is relatively Nitya compared to every other thing that is manifest after Akasha. It is Nitya. But Brahma is really Nitya. Akasha is not Nitya in the sense of it exists in all three Kalas. It also resolves when there is Kalpa, Kalpanta. But they say that there is Nitya. So simply saying Nitya won't do because Apekshika Nityattvam may be included. Therefore, Nyayamata Siddha Kala. Kala also is Nitya for them. Time is Nitya. Akasha is Nitya. Actually, Kala is the Sambandha between the between Ishwara and Maya. Ishwara Maya Sambandha is Kala. And Maya is Anitya. It has Nityattvam in the sense Apekshika Nityattvam. So as per Vedanti, as per the Siddhanta, Kala is Anitya. But as per Nayayika, it is Nitya. So one may get confused that Nityattvam means, oh, Kala or Akasha, as per Nayayika, that kind of Nityattva. So to remove that, Swaprakasham is added. Swaprakasham, Akashadinam Nityattvapi. So Akasha and Kala may be Nitya in Nayayika Mata, but still Nyayamate, Tesham Jadatvena, but still Akasha and Kala are Jada. They are not sentient. So Swaprakasham here is Chaitanya Sarupam. Thereby Swaprakashatvat, Swaprakashatva Abhava, Jadatvena Swaprakashatva Abhava. Since Kala and Akasha are Jada, they cannot be Chaitanya Sarupa. Therefore Swaprakashatva Abhava Tesham. Na Ativyapti. There is no Ativyapti. Third, Swaprakasham has been said. Now what happens if Swaprakasham alone had been said? Swaprakasham Vyapakam has been said because Swaprakashatva Matra Uktau Suryadi Jyotishi Nyayamata Siddham Atma Gune Jnane Baudhanam Kshanika Vijnanatmani Cha Ativyapti Prasaktehe Tadvaranaya Vyapakam Iti Tesham Parichinnatvat Na Ativyaptihi. So Suryadi Jyotishi, if you say just Swaprakasha, Swaprakasha cannot be directly understood as Chaitanya by everyone. So they may think that, oh, Swaprakasha, of course, Swaprakasha, Chaitanya makes it Swaprakasha. Anything that is Swaprakasha, seen as Swaprakasha in the Loka also, that Surya does not borrow its light from anything else or anyone else, just like the moon does. Still, in Siddhanta, Surya Jyoti is also Swayam Jyoti, Atma Jyoti, Chaitanya Jyoti. But if it appears that Surya does not borrow light, therefore Surya has its own Jyoti as Saprakasha. Surya is also Saprakasha and other Deepa Ityadi Adi Padena. Nyayamata Siddha, Atma Gune Jnani. We saw yesterday, day before yesterday, that there is all these gunas, sukha, dukkha, ityadi, all these are sitting in the Atma as per the Nayayikas, the logicians. So jnana is also a guna. When jnana takes place, jnana is a guna. They say that the consciousness is also a guna of Atma. Therefore, that Svaprakashattvam, which is Chaitanya Swarupa, that accrues to guna, jnana guna of Atma, that reaches to that. There is a wider definition if you just say Svaprakasham, and it applies to Surya also. Surya also becomes Surya, Deepa, Ityadi, they become Lakshya. Further, Bauddhanam, the Kshanikavadis say that the consciousness is one's own, but then it is momentary consciousness. We are not talking about momentary consciousness. The sadhu does not talk about momentary consciousness when he says Svaprakasha in the Mangalacharana. He is showing the Vastu, Vastu Nirdesha Rupa Mangalacharana. So Vastu is being pointed out, thereby Vyapakam is added to remove the Ativyapti Dosha. Why? Tesham Parichinnatvat na Ativyaptihi. All these are Parichinna, they are limited. In the Bauddha Mata, the Kshanika Vijnana Atma, which is Chaitanya Swarupa, but it is momentary, therefore it is parichinna, it is limited. Then the guna, jnana guna in the nyaya siddha atma, in the nyaya mata siddha atma guna, which is jnana, which is chaitanya, there also only when the knowledge takes place, that time there is this guna manifest, therefore it is in the atma, it is seen, therefore it is also parichinna. When jnana is there, it is seen as Chaitanya Swarupa. When jnana is lacking, then something else goes on there. That is the guna. So all these limit each other. The sukha guna, dukkha guna, they limit each other. So also they limit the jnana. So parichinnatvat nati vyapti. Suryadi jyotishi also, surya jyoti ityadi is not nitya. It is limited. It can reach only a certain area. So thereby also it is limited. Thereby Vyapakam has been added. That's the reason. Atha Vyapakam. Vyapakam, what about Vyapakam being said as a Lakshana for Brahma? Only Vyapakam. All pervasive. Nama Rupayor Adhishthanam has been added because Vyapakam, Vyapakattva Matroktav Nayayika Prabhakara Matasiddhatmani Akashadav Sankhya Matasiddha Prakrutavcha Ativyaptehe तद्वारणाया नाम रूपयो अधिष्ठानम इति पूर्वोक्तेषु आकाशादिषु त्रिषु व्यापकत्वांगीकारे अपि नाम रूपयो अधिष्ठानत्वात् नाम रूपयो अधिष्ठानत्व अनंगीकारात् नति व्याप्तिः. सो व्यापकम्, इफ व्यापकम् हैज हैड बीन सेड ओनली व्यापकत्व, देन नैयायिक प्राभाकर, प्राभाकर मतलब प्राभाकर मतलब इज वन कर्मकांडी मतलब पूर्व मीमांसक मतलब. सो नैयायिक एंड प्राभाकर से that in Atma and Akasha, Atma, Akasha and Sankhya Mata Siddha Prakrutam. Sankhya Mata Siddha Prakruti is Pradhana. Their Ativyapti is there because they say that all these are Vyapaka Tattvas. Atma is Vyapaka, but Atma is individualized. Being individual, it is Vyapaka. So Nyaya and Prabhakara, Prabhakara Mata and Nayayika Mata says that every Jiva individually is Vyapaka, but individualized as well. How? Bhagavan knows. How can it be Vyapaka Atma and individualized? There cannot be a logic behind that. But they say, yes, it is all Vyapaka. So if we ask them, if I am everywhere and you are everywhere, we are overlapping each other, they'll say, yes, everybody is overlapping each other in Chaitanya. So Vyapakatva व्यापकत्व मात्रोक्तौ नैयायिक प्राभाकर मत सिद्ध आत्मनि आकाशादौ सांख्य मत सिद्ध प्रकृतो प्रधान व्यापक तत्व देर इज अतिव्याप्ति देर देर बाय नाम रूपयो अधिष्ठानम हैज बीन सेड इट इज अ सबस्ट्रैटम ऑफ नाम एंड रूप बट इन देर केस इट इज नॉट अ सबस्ट्रैटम आत्मा इज नॉट अ सबस्ट्रैटम प्रकृति इज नॉट अ सबस्ट्रैटम ऑफ नाम एंड रूप पूर्वोक्तेषु आकाशादिषु त्रिषु व्यापकत्व अंगीकारे अपि इवन इफ यू एक्सेप्ट दि व्यापकत्व इन दि अर्लियर नाउ हियर व्यापक हैज बीन सेड अर्लियर व्यापकत्व हैज बीन डिनाइड फॉर दि सूर्यादि ज्योति न्याय मत सिद्ध आत्म गुण एंड बौद्धानां क्षणिक विज्ञान आत्मनि ओनली इन गुण हियर आत्म गुण वॉज मेन्शन हियर आत्मा इज बीन मेन्शन आत्मा एज पर नैयायिक इज व्यापक दि गुण ज्ञान गुण इज नॉट व्यापक बिकॉज गुण इज सीन ओनली वेन इट इज मैनिफेस्ट देयर बाय व्यापकम हैज बीन एडेड टू डिनाई दि लक्षणा टू रीच दि लक्ष्य विच इज आत्मगुण ज्ञान सूर्यादि ज्योतिष एंड बौद्धानां क्षणिकवादिनां आत्मा क्षणिकवादी आत्मा कैनॉट बी व्यापक बिकॉज इट इज क्षणिक बाय द वेरी नेचर ऑफ बीइंग क्षणिक इट कैनॉट बी व्यापक हियर वाइल व्यापक हैज बीन एक्सेप्टेड देर पूर्वोक्तेषु आकाशादिषु व्हाट वाज सेड अबाउट आकाश इत्यादि विच वाज स्टेटेड अर्लियर त्रिषु व्यापकत्व अंगीकारे अपि इवन इफ व्यापकत्वम कैन इज एक्सेप्टेड देन नाम रूपे अधिष्ठानत्व अंगीकारात इट इज नॉट द अधिष्ठान नोबडी सेज एक्सेप्ट फॉर अद्वैत इन नोबडी सेज दैट देर इज अधिष्ठान फॉर नाम रूप नाम रूप बिकम्स रियल फॉर देम फॉर अस इट इज ऑल कल्पित देयरफॉर नाति व्याप्ति ही दैट्स व्हाई नाम रूपे अधिष्ठान फर्दर नाम रूपे अधिष्ठान एंड स्वप्रकाशम हियर स्वप्रकाशम शुड बी अंडरस्टूड एज दी अदर विशेषण विच इज बुद्ध्यबोध्यम बुद्धेर्दुक् दैट्स व्हाई इट इज रिटन इन ब्रैकेट दैट स्वप्रकाशम हैज ऑलरेडी बीन कंसिडर्ड इन पॉइंट थ्री इन पॉइंट फाइव द पेयर टेकन इज रियली नाम रूपे अधिष्ठान एंड बुद्धे बुद्ध्यबोध्यम बुद्ध्यबोध्यम बुद्धेर्दृक् साक्षी स्वरूप नाम रूपे अधिष्ठानत्व मात्रोक्तौ प्रातिभासिक सर्पादि नाम रूप अधिष्ठान रज्वादौ अतिव्याप्तिः तद्वारणाय स्वप्रकाशं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक् इति वाइज इट सेड एज साक्षी बुद्धेर्दृक् एंड नॉट एक्सेसिबल टू द बुद्धि इफ इट इज सेड दैट नाम रूपयो अधिष्ठानम देन दिस प्रातिभासिक सर्प रज्जु सर्प विच इज सीन Rajju which is seen as Sarpa. Rajju is not seen and only Sarpa is seen. That's what we say Rajju Sarpa. Rajju Sarpa is only after Jnanotpatti that Rajju itself appeared as Sarpa. However, when Sarpa is seen, that time one who sees Sarpa, he sees only Sarpa. Whereas the other who is seeing Rajju, he says that the former is seeing Sarpa on Rajju. So Adhishthana is Rajju. Rajju itself becoming an Adhishthana projects a Sarpa. Therefore, it is an Adhishthana, Nama Rupayo. Sarpa Namasya and Sarpa Rupasya Adhishthanam Kimiti Ukte Prishtesati. The answer is Rajju Eva. Rajju Eva Adhishthanam. So if Rajju is an Adhishthanam, then is this Nama Rupayo Adhishthanam like Rajju? No, that is Jada, it is Swaprakasha. This is Swaprakasha, it is a Sakshi. Rajju does not have Sakshi Bhava. Rajju does not have Chaitanya also. It is not Swaprakasha. Therefore, Rajvadehe. That's why Swaprakasham has been added. Rajvadehe Jadatvat Nadi Vyapti. Rajju is Jada. And Adipadena, Rajvadehe Adipadena, you can look at the whenever there is a Kalpana. There is a kalpana, you are imagining something, that time the adhishthana is buddhi or the antakkarana. In the antakkarana, you are daydreaming. Daydreaming or dreaming also. So all the others say that the dream is taking place, the mind is projecting. So mind is the adhishthana, but mind is jada. Therefore, antakkaranasya jadatvatapi na ativyaptihi. अयम च परिष्कारो मंददृष्ट्या. नाउ इन कंक्लूजन ही सेज हियर इन द फिफ्थ पॉइंट फिफ्थ पेयर ही कंक्लूड्स बाय सेइंग अयम च परिष्कारः ऑल दिस अतिव्याप्ति वारणम हैज बीन डन एज पर मंददृष्टि. दिस इज टू सैटिस्फाई मंददृष्टि इज दैट इज द रीजन मंददृष्ट्या परिष्कारः वस्तुतस्तु सिद्धांतिनः वस्तुतः फॉर अ सिद्धांति व्हाट इज वेदांती मते रज्ज्वादि सर्प कल्पनादिष्ठानम तत्तद उपहित चैतन्यम मेव. इन रियालिटी वॉट इज द अधिष्ठान रज्जु इज नॉट द अधिष्ठान फॉर रज्जु सर्प. वाय बिकॉज रज्जु फॉर द प्रातिभासिक सर्प व्यावहारिक रज्जु इज द अधिष्ठान बट व्यावहारिक रज्जु इज कल्पित. व्यावहारिक रज्जु इज ऑल्सो कल्पित. देर फोर द प्रातिभासिक सर्प एज वेल एज द व्यावहारिक रज्जु हैव ओनली चैतन्य एज अधिष्ठान. सो तत्तद उपहित तत्तद मीन्स सर्प उपहित एज वेल एज रज्जु उपहित चैतन्यमेव अधिष्ठानम. देर इज नो अदर अधिष्ठान बिकॉज एवरीथिंग व्यावहारिक एज वेल एज प्रातिभाषिक सत्ता इज नॉट रियली सत्ता. इट इज ऑल कल्पित. ऑन वॉट? ऑन चैतन्य विच इज द ओनली सत् ओनली त्रिकालाबाधि सत्. अतः नाम रूपयोर अधिष्ठानम इति एव लक्षणम. देयर इज नो अदर लक्षण नीडेड. ओनली दैट इज सफिशिएंट. नाम रूपयोर अधिष्ठानम इति एव लक्षणम इन सिद्धांत. दैट इज व्हाई वी गेट अवे बाय सेइंग ओनली अधिष्ठान. इफ वी से अधिष्ठान फॉर अस इट इज ओनली चैतन्य. स्टिल ही एनालाइजेस फर्दर स्वप्रकाशम मीनिंग बुद्ध्य बोध्यम बुद्धेर्दृक्. दैट शुड हैव बीन सेड. दैट वुड हैव बीन सफिशिएंट हैड इट बीन. He would have said that, but Nirmalam has been added. Svaprakashatva matroktu keshanchid upasakanam mate atmani ativyaptehe tadvaranaya nirmalam iti. So there are many who do upasanas. Why do they do upasanas? For shuddhi. They don't consider as for chitta shuddhi. Siddhanta says that for chitta shuddhi you do upasana. Upasana as per karmakanda is for the देवता स्वरूप प्राप्ति देवता जन्म प्राप्ति और डिफरेंट लोक प्राप्ति ब्रह्म लोक प्राप्ति अलॉन्ग विथ कर्म. बट उपासना एज पर सिद्धांत इज ऑल्दो वी एग्री दैट इट कैन गिव ब्रह्म लोक ऑल्सो इट विल नॉट गिव मोक्ष. दैट ब्रह्मलोकत्व ब्रह्मलोक प्राप्ति विल बी ओनली लिमिटेड इन टाइम. There is a good possibility that there will be janma again. Thereby, krama mukti may be possible, but nitya mukti here and now, jivan mukti is not possible. So, we say that upasanas should be done for chitta shuddhi. If you get chitta shuddhi, then shravana will bear fruit. Otherwise, shravana will be shuddha shravana. Acharya used to say shuddha shravana, meaning you listen and it goes out the same year, or at the most it reaches the other year and goes out. It does not stay because chitta shuddhi is lacking. Upasana has to be done for chitta shuddhi. Some others think svaprakashatva matrokto keshanchid upasakanam. For some upasakas, they think that this upasana is going to make me shuddha. Atma shuddhi will take place because atma is ashuddha in their thinking. This is also the, it can also be taken as the, all the Dvaita Mata as well. Because all the Dvaitis think that there is Aumsha Aumshi Bhava or some separation is there. And when there is Shuddhi by Bhakti or Upasana, there is merging. So all the different kinds of mokshas that they have, Sarupya, Salokya, Samipya, Sayujya, all these four types of moksha, is through some kind of shuddhi. They tap the grace, but through shuddhi of atma. Atma is limited. Even in Aumsha Aumshi Bhava, there is a limitedness because you do not have the purity of the Lord. That is one aspect. He is Ananta Kalyana Guna Delte. Say, the Ishvara is Ananta Kalyana Guna. Whereas, I have barely any guna, let alone Ananta Kalyana. This is the thinking. So, atmani ativyaptehe tadvaranaya nirmalam iti. They don't think that atma is nirmala. जीवात्मा इज नॉट निर्मला फॉर देम. देयरफॉर उपासक मते तु आत्मनः स्वप्रकाशत्वेऽपि एंड स्वप्रकाशत्वम इवन इफ इट इज देयर फॉर उपासक अविद्यादि मलत्वेन एव अभ्युपगमात् न अतिव्याप्तिः. अभ्युपगमवाद. सो वी डोंट एग्री बट वी से इवन इफ वी एक्सेप्ट दैट अविद्यादि मला इज देयर इन द आत्मा एंड कंसिडरिंग दैट इट इज मला टू द आत्मा वी ऑल्सो से अविद्या इज इन द आत्मा. Where is it? Brahma. Bhamati will say in the Jivatma. Bhamati Kara says Jivatma. Vivarana says Brahma. Both are the same. We need not worry about that. But neither says that that avidya adi mala affects the Atma because it is mithya. Avidya, avidya, karya, all of that is mithya. But the upasaka mate, there is reality to that mala. Avidya adi dosha will affect the Atma and it affects the Atma, therefore Nirmala has been added by giving, you know, hypothetically accepting it. That is Abhyupagama. Okay, then you should have said Nirmala. Why did you not say only Nirmala? Why Apara has been added? Nirmalatva matroktau sankhyavimate atmani ativyapti sambhava tadvaranaya aparam iti. तन्मते आत्मनो देशकाल परिच्छेदाभावेपि वस्तु परिच्छेदस्य इष्टत्वात् तस्य अपि अभावात् ब्रह्मणो न अतिव्याप्तिः. सो ओनली इफ प्यूरिटी हैज बीन मेंशन्ड निर्मला देन सांख्याभिमते आत्मनि अतिव्याप्तिः संभवात्. व्हाई? बिकॉज दे थिंक दैट आत्मा इज निर्मला. Atma is a bhokta, but not a karta. So bhoga is sukha bhoga mostly. There can be dukkha also, but only a bhokta. The kartrutva, whatever the prakriti, pradhana does, it does not affect the Atma at all. Atma is not a karta. Very strange, you know, not being a karta becomes a bhokta. Whether it is the supreme purusha or whether it is the individual jivatma purusha. As per them. So Nirmalatvam is there. If Nirmalatvam, some sort of Nirmalatvam has to be accepted in the Sankhya Matha. Sankhya is, except for that Dvaita that they have, all sorts of Vedas, Sankhya is very close to Advaita Vedanta also. That's why we build over Sankhya and refute only what is erroneous, what is the Dvaita conclusion that we refute. That's why Sankhya and Yoga both are acceptable unless they hold on to Dvaita conclusion. So we refute the conclusion of Dvaita, Bheda between Jiva and Paramatma, Jiva, Bheda between Jiva and Jiva, and Bheda between Jiva and Jagat. If they give up these three, Panchadashikara says that, Bhagavan Vidyaranacharya says that if Sankhya and Yoga give up these three Bhedas, then it is acceptable to Vedantins. So Nirmalattvam is there. With Nirmalattvam, Aparattvam is not there in Sankhya Mata. Therefore, Tanmate Atmana Desha Kala Parichheda Bhavayapi. Desha and Kala Parichheda is not there. Because Atma is not limited in space. Sankhya say that Atma is Vyapaka. Kala Parichheda is not there. Atma is not limited in time. However, Vastu Paricheda is there because I am a different Atma than you, another Atma and yet another Atma and yet another Atma, and there is another Paramatma who you can never become. Thereby, the differences are real. Vastu Paricheda is there. Me, Atma as a Vastu and you, Atma as a Vastu are different. Therefore, Vastu Parichedasya Ishtatvat in their Mata. Not in Tanmate, not in Siddhanti Mate. In Siddhanta, Apara has been added, Tasya Api Abhavat, Brahmano Nati Vyaptihi. So, Vastu Paricheda Abhava is there in Siddhanta. Atma is Ekameva Dvitiya. There is no second, let alone differences. There has to be second to have a difference, whether Desha, Kala or Vastu Paricheda. It is possible only if there is another. There is not only another Atma, there is no Anatma also. अनात्मा इज मिथ्या, वेर एज आत्मा भेदा इज मिथ्या, आत्मा इज वन. सो दिस कंक्लूड्स द पेयर्स. नाउ व्हाई सो मेनी विशेषणास हैव बीन गिवन, दैट हैज टू बी इक्वल टू अनेक विशेषणानां प्रयोजनम. व्हाट इज द पर्पस? पूर्वोक्त आत्मलक्षणेषु सुखम नित्यम नित्यम स्वप्रकाशम इति द्वाभ्याम द्वाभ्याम एव लक्षणाभ्याम सर्वत्र अतिव्याप्ति दोष निवृत्तौ अपि अनेक अनेकधा अनेकधा अतिव्याप्ति निरासोक्तिस्तु लक्षण प्रयोजनेषु विस्पष्टार्थरुचीनां सर्वप्रकारेण ब्रह्मज्ञानोत्पत्तये. सो फॉर अस इट इज वेरी सिंपल. व्हाई डू वी एनालाइज दिस तर्क? Why do we have anything to do with Nayayakas? We do because we have one step as per Shruti, which is Manana. People do not do Manana and say, I have understood everything. Question. If somebody is questioned, need not explain to the other, but that question should not become one's own. If you own up others' question, even if you are not able to answer the other, it is fine, but you should be able to convince yourself. You should have conviction. Not only because Shruti says it would be paroksha jnana. Paroksha jnana is only manana siddha. So manana is tarkatmaka. Manana cannot, we cannot do away with the logic. What is given up in Vedanta, just like the dvaita bhava is given up of sankhyas and yoga, yogis, we accept everything else. Similarly, we accept everything that is in Tarka that concludes in Shruti. Shush, not Shushka Tarka, but that which concludes in the Shruti Siddhanta, we accept that Tarka. So Tarka is as a process we accept, which is not contrary to Shruti also we accept. Not only concluding there, but which is not contradicting Shruti, we accept. What we do not accept is the Dvaita conclusion as well as what their philosophy is. Their philosophy that Atma has guna and so many things, you know, as to where is the guna resting. All these are refuted wholesale by Panchadashikara in the first chapter itself in mere two shlokas. The Purvapakshi questions the Siddhantin as to where is this Nirguna Brahma of yours. If it is Nirguna, then you cannot talk about Nirgunatvam itself becomes a guna. So such discussion is intended there, but Bhagavan Vidyaranacharya refutes it in one shloka. One shloka or two shlokas at the most he refutes. I think in the first one shloka he refutes such a possibility by countering the Nayayika with a question and dismantling the entire Nayayika's philosophy itself by the same process. Showing all sorts of doshas, not only this, it shows anyonya ashraya dosha, so all mutual dependencies, chakraka dosha, swashraya dosha, all doshas are shown in the Nayayika philosophy itself. So logical flaws exist in the logic of Nayayikas. And they claim to be logicians. So he insults them for asking a question based on logic where they don't have a system of logic which is working. Still, we have to use it because logic is the only thing that Buddhi agrees with. Buddhi cannot rest if there are questions. And if there are questions, moksha becomes an impossibility. Nishtha will not be possible. Nididhyasanam will become bahuduram. Therefore, manana is needed after shravana. During shravana also, it is mananatmaka. There is an overlap between shravana and manana. Goes back and forth. Till there are no pramana and prameya shankas remaining, and finally one lands in nididhyasana. Therefore, aneka visheshananam prayojanam kim siddhantinastu. There is only one prayojana, brahmajnanotpattaye, sarva prakarana brahmajnanotpattaye eva, really. However, we use the purvapakshi as a tool. Purvokta atmalakshaneshu sukham nityam and nityam saprakasham, all these pairs, two each would have sufficed. Any two you pick among the seven pairs given, any two visheshanas will be a perfect lakshana. It will not have any kind of dosha. No ativyapti is possible still. Dvabhyam dvabhyam eva lakshanabhyam sarvatra ativyapti dosha nivritta opi. Even if ativyapti dosha nivritti will take place with any pair, still अनेकधा अतिव्याप्ति निरासोक्तिस्तु वाइट हैज बीन डन तल्लक्षण प्रयोजनेषु विस्पष्टार्थरुचीनाम विस्पष्टार्थरुचीनाम वी वांट टू नो विथ एनी पेयर हाउ इट इज पॉसिबल दैट्स व्हाई इट इज शोन सो दैट योर बुद्धि बिकम्स तीव्र एंड मनना बिकम्स मोर एंड मोर फ्रूटफुल मोर एंड मोर पॉसिबल This is for a Siddhanti, not for others. We do not really have any arguments with others. Taihi ayam na viruddhyate, says Bhagavan Karikakara. There cannot be any opposition of all the mithya philosophies with satya, which is this Shruti is talking about as Brahma ekameva dvitiya. Ekameva dvitiya Brahma cannot have any tarka. Tarka is all in dvaita. But there it is not to argue with them, but for our own benefit. Therefore, sarva prakarena brahma jnanotpattaye eva. Eva kara can be added for our own, because it is brahma jnanotpattaye. Tadarthya chaturthi. Purvokta akhila lakshana lakshita chinmatra brahma eva aham na paragrupaiti mangalartha. So what is the mangalacharana for vastu nirdesha rupa? Purvokta akhila lakshana lakshita. That chit which is there, चिन्मात्र चिदेव चिन्मात्र चिदेव चिन्मात्र पूर्वोक्त अखिल लक्षण लक्षित चिन्मात्र ब्रह्मैव ऑल दिस विशेषणास विच आर गिविंग टू गिवन टू शो दैट वेरी चिन्मात्र ब्रह्म विच आई एम न परागरूपः इति नॉट यू नो द वन फोकस आउटवर्ड दैट आउटवर्ड विद द कोश Sambandha, identifying with the kosha as me, claiming every guna of the anatma kosha as atma guna, knowingly or unknowingly, that kind of a tadatmya sambandha is not there. Really not there for Brahma, and that Brahma eva aham, na paragrupaha anatma or atma anatma mishrita. Iti mangalartha, this is the mangalacharanartha. Okay, before we go to the others, I have, so let's stop here. Let's stop here. We'll continue in the next part, where we'll look at Akshepas. We'll continue tomorrow. So, Sapratyagatma Vishaya ka Mangala Charana Vishaya Akshepa Samadhan. So, there is Purva Pakshana to this Mangala. Why did you take your own Atma? Therefore, there are a lot of Akshepas. We'll look at that Akshepa and Samadhana in the next part. सुखम नित्यम सप्रकाशम व्यापकम नाम रूपयो अधिष्ठानम बुद्धि बोध्यम बुद्धेर यत्तो निर्मलम अपारम सर्व वेदांत वेद्यम प्रत्यक परम तदेव अहम् नमत्तोन्यत इति मे निश्चिता मतिः एनी क्वेश्चंस सॉरी आई गेट कैरीड अवे दैट्स व्हाई आई हैव केप्ट एन अलार्म सो दैट आई डोंट मिस समथिंग व्हिच इज कमिंग अप सो हियर अ बीप एट द एंड ऑफ द क्लास To mark the end of the class. Any questions? Okay, namaste.
Hari Om.
Yes, Amma.
Point number three, sir. Explain. Point number three.
I can't hear you, Amma.
Oh, one second.
What's the question, Amma?
Yes, are you able to hear?
Yeah. What's the question?
So the question was the point number three, sarva vyapakatvam and other one.
Yeah.
So prakasham and vyapakatvam.
Yeah.
Can you explain that to me?
Oh, please listen to the recording. No, please ask a pointed question or listen to the recording because I don't understand. Explain again means what? Because swaprakasham we have seen swaprakasham and vyapakam. Listen to the recording. Okay. If you have a specific question, please ask. Please don't ask me to explain again because I've already explained. There's hardly any time left. I'll try to cover up tomorrow if you still have a question. Please send a message as to what exactly is the problem here.
Okay. No. Okay. I wanted to ask about this Baudhara.
It is Kshanika Vijnana, that's all. Don't focus much on Baudha, this thing. Kshanika Vijnana, it is momentary consciousness, that's all. They have momentary consciousness. We don't agree with consciousness being momentary. That is all.
Okay.
So, momentariness cannot be vyapaka. Vyapaka is basically that is all pervasive. So, there should be no limitation of any sort. When you say it is momentary, there is kala parichinnattvam is there.
Yeah. Okay.
Thereby vyapakattvam is not there in their mata.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh yeah, I got clarified.
Yeah. Because if you give me a broad question to explain again, it is very difficult, you know. So if you give me a pointed question, it is easier.
No, I was about to point that question. So meanwhile, you explain that. Okay.
Yeah, I understand. Okay, thank you. Namaste.